So we're making videos in a row. Here's the next system. This is the Presario 6000. Improved easy access design. Clareel and Windows XP with an Athlon XP processor. It's got some FireWire. I'm gonna set you guys down over here so I can spin the tower around. Gotta go get a new tripod. This thing is terrible. Alright, so we're gonna spin the tower around. I need like a turntable or something they had at my Goodwill at one point. Didn't pick them up because that's not computer equipment. So there's our power supply, which hopefully is embedded. Keyboard, mouse, USBs, Ethernet. Got the same weird port colors. And modem for the FireWire card. We're missing the PCIe expansion door. And a rear case fan, but I think I saw the rear fan. Bezel removal and location of extra drive screws. That's pretty interesting. And here's the inside of the system. We got our Athlon XP processor, something amount of RAM. This one has an AGP expansion slot in it. Some old hard drives. Do we have an NVIDIA? We do have an NVIDIA chipset in here. Nice if I can zoom in on that. I think it's right about there. There's our NVIDIA chipset. So that's pretty cool. So basically, we're going to seal this thing back up and we're going to try it out. Let's see what's going on. Let's see if this is rocking. Yeah. So they're all designed for Microsoft Windows XP. They all have a Home Edition product key on them. Well, not the other ones we're going to take a look at here in a second, but these two, as I mentioned, and this one are designed for Home Edition. So that's, I presume, what was put on here. Talk. Realign the monitor with the camera here. I moved it after the last video. So let's connect this up. I'm trying to keep these videos just as long and on and on as possible so I don't have to edit an entire thing. This is a large spark. Okay, let's see what happens when I press the power button. Okay, power supply fan is spinning. We have no output. Both indicator lights in the front are on. Try again. Yeah, we got nothing. Okay, so let's go ahead and crack the thing open. And see what our issue is. This way, let's go and power it on. These AMD systems just like to sometimes just die, but I have a feeling that the RAM is probably not inserted correctly, so we're gonna try doing that first. Start with the basics. So let's go ahead and unplug that. Click that on. Let's take our RAM. Try an AGP graphics card if the onboard graphics are no good. 256 megs of memory. Out, one stick left. Oh, no, that was it. Yeah, monitor's on, so. I don't know how much RAM is left in this system now, but I do have a spare stick of RAM in my room, so we have 256 megabytes of memory. I'm gonna try to reseat this. I'd at least like to have 512 in here to utilize the computer. But if we can't, then that's fine. Might have gotten shaken around, or maybe the stick's just dead. No good. This is our. Let's plug this in. Let's see if the power's on. Yeah, that's a problem. We have the plague stick of RAM. There's a lot of dust in this thing. I do have some spare RAM that I can throw in here, maybe. So. Oh boy. Alright, yeah, so that's out.
Let's go ahead.
You're running Unix. Okay, so we're gonna press F to save changes. Alright, what's our bet that's gonna be on here? Windows XP, okay. Both Alpha drives are empty and both work. So that's cool. Easy access design, now even simpler to upgrade or replace components. Oh boy, alright. Sounds pretty good. Okay. The same deal with this one. I believe we already reinstalled Windows on this a while back at his house. So, there's no goodies on this system. We did install the NVIDIA graphics driver on here. So we have an AMD Athlon XP 2100 Plus. So that's pretty good. GeForce 2 integrated graphics. And if we bring the cam down a little bit. No, we don't have a processor section. Okay. We'll go through these in depth a little bit later, but looks to be good enough. So this system, yeah, pretty easy fix. Just some bad memory stick in there. And other than that, we're pretty good. So yeah, so that was that video. The compact works just fine. I got a couple more to do. I got a large compact Presario with the Windows 98 on it, but I'll probably do that in a little bit. I'm just going to shut off the tower. I'm not worried about this today. I have an IBM that I'd like to try and get to work, so. Cool. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, and see you all in the next one.